Jonathan Krinsky, he is Baycrest's chief market technician. It's good to see you. I wanted to bring you in earlier because it's not like John Rogers is out there on an island by himself. You think the value move has legs. You said the following, and then I want you to explain it. We thought that the bond move last week was capitulatory in the short term and a relief rally would ensure allowing growth names to bounce. Well, that played out to an extent. On Monday, the last 2 days have totally reversed that trend, and now growth finds itself in a precarious spot. How precarious?
Well, yeah, I think at the heart of this whole trade is the bond move. And if we go back to last week, we saw one of the most extreme capitulatory moves to the downside in bond prices we've seen in the last two decades. We had TLT trade its second highest amount of notional volume on record, only preceded by when it put in its all-time high almost a year ago in March. And then you had it about 13% below its 200-day moving average. And to put that in context, that's about the widest spread below its 200-day it's been in the last two decades of which we have data. So that was the capitulatory move. Bonds should have bounced strongly off of that move, which is what we thought we would get when we came in this week. When something is that oversold and can't bounce and it can't muster a rally, and, you know, it still could, but, you know, we're out here four or five days post that move and bonds are still moving flat to lower. When it can't bounce, that tells you that primary trend is pretty strong. The momentum, the downside momentum in bond prices is strong. And so if we think that bond prices move lower and interest rates continue to move flat or higher, mm-hmm. it makes it a much more difficult case to be buying growth relative to value. And I think some of the topics you guys hit on make sense. I don't think that you necessarily, if you think value outperforms, if you think value has momentum to the upside, I don't think you have to see growth necessarily move down. We've seen that in the last few days. We're seeing it a little bit more today.
Seeing it right now. I mean, you're seeing it in real time, right? We're watching it right. Literally in real time. As the move gets higher in rates, the move gets lower in the NASDAQ particularly, but now we're all the way in the red across the board. I'm just going to tell the guys in the back, get Leisman back with us if you can, too, because I want him to participate in this conversation.